Yeah, Keith Goodrich here, turning product owner at Mastercam, and our team, Team 24, is in charge of all things turning. So that includes everything from lathe on up to mill turn, your full-blown five-axis dual spindle multi-stream machines. So the technical preview and beta areas of our release cycle are really important to us. It gives us a chance to get something into the user's hands, and then they can give us feedback, you know, what they like, what they don't like, and hopefully we'll have time before the release to actually make those modifications and get them what they're asking for. Even before the technical preview area of the release cycle, we reach out to resellers and some customers who've reached out to us over the previous year. We talk about what their needs are for the year coming up, and we give them a glimpse of, you know, this is what we're thinking for this release cycle. How would you feel about something like that? And it's a really iterative process going back and forth with customers, resellers, all kinds of different stakeholders. 2, maybe 3 years ago, we started working on work support components for Mastercam Millturn. We introduced SteadyRest last year, but there's so many people out there that have more than one steady rest. You get longer machines, you need to support those long work pieces. For Mastercam 2023, we really opened up the steady rest to support multiple tandem steady rests mounted on one block that move together, and also multiple independent steady rests that can have their own set of axes and move around the machine on their own. In lathe, when you've got the part handling operations, you can define the tool plane that they're going to use, and the tool plane has a work offset that's associated with it. We've given users the ability in Millturn to set an active tool plane before creating their part handling operations. Then those part handling operations are going to use that tool plane, and if there's a work offset associated with it, they'll come out with the proper work offset. So if you've, say, moved your part out 5 inches from where it previously was, and then you go to do a facing tool path, if you're using the new tool plane with the proper work offset, your facing tool path will be at Z0 in the posted code as you expect. It won't be 5 inches from where your previous work offset was. It's just a general quality of life improvement that people have been asking for a while. If you're gripping the part in the right spindle with your steady rest and you want to be 5 inches in from the front of the part, you'd like to see that 5-inch value in the posted code. It's not referencing the left spindle as you're working on the right. You want to be able to assign the proper spindle to the steady rest operations where you're going to use them. These quality of life improvements make all the difference to the user. It's something that you don't think about unless you're missing it. People have been asking for B-axis turning for a number of years in Mastercam. It's been a large project for us. It's multiple years, and we've got a great solution for Mastercam 2023. B-axis turning is extremely powerful because it allows you to cut the entire profile in one operation with one tool. Being able to rotate the tool while it's in the cut allows it to reach previously unreachable areas. You'd have to come in with a second tool and another entire operation, and then deal with blending the operations together. It would just make a mess of your surface finish. But with B-axis rotating while you're in the cut, it's all one cut, so there's no more mismatch. For the first release of B-axis turning, we've got two modes. We've got automatic and manual. Automatic is just like it sounds. You pick your contour, you pick your tool, and Mastercam's gonna give you a good tool path, and it's gonna reach as much of the contour as physically possible within the tool angle limits that you've defined. Manual mode allows the users to define as many tool axis control lines as they want to control the orientation of the tool along the cut. If you know that you wanna start at 90 degrees and then just rotate 10 degrees by the time you're at the end of the cut, 2 tool axis control lines is all that you'll need to get that done. One of the most rewarding things that I've experienced is when you're in that technical preview or beta cycle and people are asking for new functionality to the new stuff that you've already given them, it shows us that they're excited about it, they're in there, they're using it, and they want more of what we've given them. So we're already hard at work for the next release on some good enhancements for it. We take all feedback extremely seriously. We look at it together as a team, and we decide on which items to act. And often when we do act on items, we'll find that original user and reach out to them and ask them, hey, we've acted on your feedback. What do you think about it? So that really closes the circle, and it's a great feeling for us. And I've got to assume it's an even better feeling for the user to know that they're helping shape Mastercam. This is Mastercam 2023.